From the East Coast straight to McKinney, Texas, let's see what Lisa is cooking up for us.
As a realtor, I have met a lot of amazing people, and throughout my journey in real estate, it's so hard to stay connected to those best friends that you want to stay connected to in real estate. So tonight, we are getting together for my gourmet group here in McKinney, Texas, and I want to introduce you to some of the most successful, savvy, influential, funny women in real estate. So pull up a chair, grab a cocktail, and let me introduce you to my gourmet girls.
Awesome.
Show us around. I want to see your home.
Okay, well, come on in.
How long have you been building this?
So it took us 19 months to build it.
Wow.
And it took all 17 years of ideas of seeing just house after house, all my favorite things, and I put it into this one house.
Oh, I love it.
It was really like doing a 3D puzzle.
Yeah.
So picked out every detail. I don't want to do it again.
It is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, I would not change a thing. I'm just in awe.
One of the neat things about the house is that you can kind of see through rooms in the house. When I'm in the backyard laying by the pool, I can see through that door, the music room, the kitchen windows. I can see all the way through and see nature everywhere. But the home itself, it's a 4-bedroom, 5,500 square feet. It's shaped like an H, and I say that so you kind of have your bearings. So we basically have two wings. I feel like a flight attendant. Two wings this way and two wings this way. And so I wanted everything to be open and together because we entertain a lot. We have 5 sons.
Wow.
And our families are growing. So I wanted everybody to not be left out and be together. And then we open these sliders and, you know, kind of let the outside in. And I have drop down screens so we can leave them open because you know how Texas is.
Yes.
With the bugs.
Oh, I hate the flies.
I know, mosquitoes. And the mosquitoes love my husband.
This is tile.
Yeah, it looks like backward, but it's tile. Yeah. And I went with the 24 by 48.
Okay.
Which I also did on the floor, which you don't see very often.
Yeah.
And I loved it. And then again, sticking with the theme of looking at the outdoors, our outdoor dining area to the right, it has a view on 2 full walls. And you can just see the entire backyard. I love that this is a pie-shaped lot. So you have different angles. Again, I love angles.
How many acres is it?
It's 1 acre.
Just one.
But just beyond.
It feels like
it's dead.
It feels like it's bigger.
And we're on a cul-de-sac, which is known as the party plaza. Apparently,
party plaza.
All of the neighbors come down here for the parties.
Okay.
And we just, you know, have a few steps to our door.
Okay.
So fun. So anyway, but yeah, I wanted everything to be together. Again, windows looking up to the front with the front courtyard. I love to entertain. You know that about
yes.
me. And I wanted it to be friendly for that. I wanted it to be how people would feel welcome. And I think we accomplished it.
Oh, definitely.
See my boxing?
Oh!
So I grow all my... I grow this for gourmet.
No.
So I grow kale and chard and spinach for my green smoothies. And then I have the green leaf lettuce and romaine and red leaf lettuce. And then we also inside grow sprouts.
Wow. So you make a salad tonight?
Yeah, I'll make the salad tonight. I'll just go to my farm stand.
I've actually never seen one of these in person. Like I've seen them.
You can get it with 6 tiers. I think 4 is plenty, but we can't block the TV.
No.
The priorities, right?
No, yeah.
So.
Love it.
Yeah.
I'm so glad you made it. You look so cute. It's a cute outfit. Aww. Come on in.
Hi. Welcome to my home.
It's nice to meet you.
So I had an inspector, and he was inspecting the car. crawl space down, you know, down below. And he opened up the crawl space, and you know, you have to get in that little jumpsuit, and you have to go down there, and it's very, you know, very shallow. Yeah, so scary. Because I was asking him, like, what's the scariest thing you've ever seen down there? Was it a snake? Was it a rat? Was it, you know? Yeah. And so he said, well, he goes, I was down there, and then all of a sudden, it felt like somebody put a finger in my ear.
Uh-huh.
And so he just raced out of there. I mean, he's like literally like on his legs and his arms hitting the beams down there. His face comes up, he's bloody, and he tells the agent, you know, it was me. He was like, hey, I just felt something, like it felt like a finger go into my ear. And it was a monkey.
Oh no, I was screaming.
No, it really was a monkey.
You're doing it. Oh my God.
Yeah. That's what he was calling. Yeah. Yeah. And so the lady was going around.
Like on the loose?
Some lady was going door to door and saying, have y'all seen my monkey? Have y'all seen my monkey?
They probably called the police and her thinking she was crazy. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
great.
I love you, girl.
Oh, my God.
Come on.
She has a dream. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.